On March 10th, 2014, in a game between the Columbus Blue Jackets and Dallas Stars, Stars' Rich Peverly would tragically collapse on the bench due to a cardiac event, causing the game to be postponed to a later date. And when it was rescheduled, the NHL had a decision to make. No, not because Peverly collapsed on the bench, but because before the game was postponed, Jackets' Nathan Horton would score a goal, giving his team a 1-0 lead. So, instead of having the game start from scratch, the NHL gave the Jackets the goal, making the game 1-0. Nothing before the puck would even drop for a new 60-minute game. Now, Horton had a chance to score yet another goal, right? Well, just one problem.
Stars are going to start a game down 1-0. There was a goal scored in that game on the power play about 3 minutes in. Nathan Horton scored the goal for the Columbus Blue Jackets. He won't even be playing in tonight's game. He's injured.
In the month before the game was set to be replayed, Nathan Horton would suffer a season-ending injury and wouldn't be able to play in the rematch, meaning that Horton became the only player since the 1989-90 season to be credited with a goal in a game in which he didn't even play in. Sadly, the injury Horton faced not only ended his season, but eventually ended his career. As afterwards, Horton would be diagnosed with a back injury of the lumbar region, ending his season and jeopardizing his career that would unofficially end once being dealt to the Leafs for the sole purpose of being placed on LTIR. Although this record has some unfortunate injuries tied to it, it's still crazy to say the least. But if you thought scoring one goal was hard, try scoring three, as that's exactly what Ken Doherty did way back in 1934 when he would not only score a hat trick, but did so in overtime. Now, the reason this was able to happen is easy to explain. In 1928, the NHL made a rule that created a 10-minute overtime period in which a goal wouldn't automatically end the game. Instead, both teams would have the entire 10-minute period to score as many goals as they could, and the team with the lead by the end of the period would be the winners, kind of like the overtime rules the NBA has today. However, the rule would eventually be dropped in 1943 along with overtime altogether. This was because of World War II. Overtime wouldn't be brought back again until 1983, and it was once again sudden death. But this time, the first goal scored would ultimately end the game. Now, back to Doherty, as he would play hero that night in a game between the Leafs and Senators. Both teams were tied 4 goals apiece headed into the overtime period, and Doherty would step up, scoring not only the game-winning goal, but adding an additional 2 goals during the 10-minute period, finishing the frame with a hat trick and giving his Maple Leafs the win 7-4, making Ken Doherty the record holder for the most goals scored in a single overtime period, a record that will never be broken. The funniest thing about all this is that Doherty's performance in that overtime alone would make up for 20% of his career production, as Doherty would finish his NHL career in 1938 only scoring 15 career goals, 3 of them being in that overtime period. Ken Danico was a hard-nosed leader who was your typical stay-at-home defenseman. He was able to lock down his opposition, allowing the Devils a better chance at controlling the game on a nightly basis. That being said, Danico was more of an assistman more than a goal scorer, which is common with most defensemen. But unlike most defensemen, Ken struggled to even tally a single goal at times, and his goalless drought would last a while. In the 98-99 season, Danico would post 2 goals and 9 assists for 11 total points. But the year after, Danico would go goalless, and he would do so again a year after that, and a year after that as well, going 3 straight seasons without scoring a single goal. He would eventually break the streak in his final season in the 02-03 season in a game against the Buffalo Sabres in October of 2002, making Danico hold the record for the most consecutive goalless games, going goalless in exactly 255 games. To blow your mind even more, within those 255 games, Danico would reach the 1,000 game mark, win a Bill Masterton trophy, and hoist a Stanley Cup before being able to score another goal. Now, there's other records more absurd than this one, such as a record literally called Most Scars on a Player's Head, and this is held by none other than Eddie Shore himself. Sorta. See, similar to the Bobby Hull record-setting lap around the rink legend, this record won't actually appear in the record books, as it was, quote, heard by someone that the legendary Bruins defenseman got a total of 19 stitches on his head after sustaining an injury. Now, Shore was known for his gritty physical play, so no one would really be shocked if this story was actually true. But for now, it's nothing but a legend that may have been made up by the man himself. Now, speaking of making things up, this next record is both extremely lengthy and extremely specific. When the Avalanche won their second Stanley Cup in 2001, history was made, for Raymond Bork that is, as 22 years of waiting finally came to an end. However, believe it or not, Bork wasn't the only player to make history that night, as Avs player Sean Podine would also make history, setting the record for none other than the most amount of time spent in equipment after winning the Stanley Cup. Like the Eddie Shore record, this is supposedly true, and apparently was done by Podine, as he wore the number 25, so in celebration of winning it all, he decided to wear his equipment for 25 hours straight in honor of his jersey number, which also means he slept in his equipment that night as well. Everyone has their own ways of celebrating a win. Some players have celebrated in bars, clubs, and even Mario Lemieux's pool, but that's a video for another time. Podine decided to celebrate in an odd yet fascinating way, making a record that can only be beaten by those daring enough to stay in their equipment for as long as Sean did. For this last part of today's video, we'll be focusing on the goaltenders, and there's no better way to start off than going all the way back to the 89-90 season, when the Quebec Nordiques set the record for the most goalies used in a single season. That record would later be tied by both the 2002-2003 Blues and the 2007-2008 Kings, and would eventually be broken by the 2018-2019 Philadelphia Flyers. Now, we all know about those Flyers as the injury bug massively affected that team, making them go through a grand total of 8 goaltenders, breaking the record by 1. The 8 goalies used by Philly that year featured Carter Hart, Brian Elliott, Anthony Stolarz, Calvin Pickard, Michael Norvirth, Alex Lyon, Mike McKenna, and the goalie who helped break the record, Cam Talbot. Obviously, going through this many goaltenders would drastically affect any team. The Flyers were no exception, going 37-37-8, missing the playoffs due to the injury bug. In fact, only one of the 4 teams that held this record made it to the playoffs, that being the 02-03 Blues, who lost in the first round to the Vancouver Canucks.
Empty net. Canadians have the extra attacker. They need 2. Brodeur looking for the goal. Down the ice.
Goalies can score goals too, and Marty Brodeur knows a thing or two about scoring goals, as he finished his illustrious career with a total of 3 of them. But one stands out amongst the rest. In a game against the Carolina Hurricanes during a delayed penalty, Canes goalie Dan Ellis started to make his way to the bench for an extra attacker. An ill-advised pass then sent the puck into their own net while Ellis was still on the ice. Ellis tried to race back, but it was already too late. However, when rewinding this sequence of events, you can see that the last Devils player to touch the puck was none other than Martin Brodeur, meaning that technically he scored on Dan Ellis, setting the record for the most goals allowed to an opposing goaltender. Other random goalie records include most points scored by a goalie in a game, set by Flames goaltender Jeff Reese with 3 helpers, longest undefeated streak by a goalie in a season, set by Jerry Cheevers with 32, and most saves by a goalie in a regular season shutout, set by former Team Canada goaltender Ben Scrivens with 59 saves. But there's only one proper way to end today's video, and that's by highlighting perhaps my favorite record on this list. That record is, quote, the farthest distance stick-handled to deke out Wayne Gretzky. The farthest distance is 100 feet, and it's held in infamy by none other than Avs netminder Patrick Waugh.
Hey Patrick, look at this! What is this? He's out of his mind. There's a penalty now. He carried the puck over center ice. You can't do that as a goalie. Patrick's nuts. Look at Dvorsky. And the fans love it.